right, just a follow-up here on replacing the gaskets that I burned. Robert at Vintage Trailer Shop sent me the gaskets, and sure enough, just like always, his gaskets are perfect and they fit. So there's two gaskets for this type of window. This is, remember, the 66 Super Shasta front window set. And the gaskets for these panel windows, awning windows is what they're actually called. I don't know why I keep calling them panel windows. It has two different gaskets. The side ones are shaped kind of square, and then, or rectangular shaped actually. And then the top gasket on all these windows is a wedge shape. And the reason they're wedge shaped is because the window moves like this. And if you had a square one, the lip under here would catch. So it's shaped like a wedge so it doesn't catch. And then the two sides and the bottom are these square or rectangular shape. So the hardest part you're gonna find in this is getting the stuff, the old stuff out. Now I'm not really sure what the easiest way to do this is as far as getting them out, but here's what I've been doing so far. All right, I discovered the trick. I remember that the only gaskets so far that were the gaskets that were easy to get out were the ones I burned. So I went ahead and took the torch and heated it up a bit here. Not much, just enough to kind of turn the rubber black a little bit on one end. You don't have to do the whole thing. And it loosened it up, and I was able to grab it, the little, you know, see how it separated? I was able to grab this piece and it popped right out, and then the whole thing just comes right out. It's still a little tough to pull, but it does come out, so take it easy. Let me make sure we're on the subject here. And just, you know, pull it up like that. Be careful so you don't break it again. And yeah, it comes out. So Robert, I talked to Robert on the phone just now, and he says he doesn't know how to do it either. He says he just messes with it, digs under it with a little hook tip and stuff until it comes out. Well, this turned out to be really easy. So I'm going to call him right back and let them know that I found the easy way to do it. And then we'll just have to clean up this aluminum here, this burn part. Might not have even needed to heat it up that much. So that's the trick. Alrighty, so I just talked to Robert and told him what I discovered. He was happy to hear that. And I'm going to send him a link to this video when it's finished. So I'm going to show you. I'm going to do this again. Watch it make a liar out of me. So I'm just going to heat up the end. Oops, if I can get this thing to keep going. It doesn't want to keep going. I'm just going to heat up the end just a bit. Heat up the aluminum around it. And see if that's enough. Because I actually set the other one on fire. Let's see what happens now. Oh, feels like it's going to come right out. And it does. Look at that. Comes right out. Oh my God, that's great. So you don't even have to burn it. Just warm it up. And that stuff comes right out of there. How about that? Okay. So that's the trick. For all you people that end up having to do this. That's the trick. Now we'll just go ahead and clean all this best we can. We'll clean up the aluminum. Make it all clean. Dig out the locking groove here that where the channel where this stuff sets down into, and then once I get it clean, I'll show you the reinstallation of the rubber. Now remember, the two sides and the bottom are the rectangular shaped gasket, and the one in the top is the wedge shaped gasket. So there's two different kinds of gasket material for where the window closes onto. And it's nice to have those sealed because you don't want water getting in when you're traveling and it's raining, and you also don't want air getting in when it's cold, so, or hot, either way. You know, you want your trailer sealed up pretty good so you can keep it warm or keep it cool, whatever you're doing. And then also with these same windows, just so you know, there's a glaze seal. Glazing is anything, that, whether it's metal, putty, goop, or solid stuff that holds glass in, that he sells. And that all worked out pretty easy. It didn't stick like this. So when I put this new piece of glass in, I ordered some of this from Robert, and it worked great. And it glaze seals in that new piece of glass. Of course, he used the black stuff on the other side, just like in the other videos I've shown you with solid pane windows. And I think he sells that too. I got it at VTS, but I believe he sells that stuff too. And it's like real thin black butyl. It's only about, it's less than a half, it's like 3/8 of an inch or 5/16 of an inch thick. You can see it under there. That goes on the metal, and then the glass goes on top. And of course, the, what you want to do is I just spray some Windex on the other side so that I can still move it around and get it centered. And then I go ahead and, because it keeps it slippery, and then I go ahead and put the glazing in to hold it in there. Alrighty, and again, let's see. Well, I don't know where the numbers are, but the, it's the HEHR 1700s, I don't know. Whatever I said in the beginning of the video, what this window set is, which I can't remember what it is. But it has these awning type windows. These are called awning windows, okay? And then solid in the middle, and then awning windows over here. So I'll clean that up, and then I'll go ahead and show you how to put these gaskets in. It's pretty simple. All right, now first I just want to clean out that groove where the stuff goes into. So I just take a little wire brush, looks like a toothbrush, stick it in there, run it back and forth, clean that out. And then if you have a compressor, you can blow the dust out. If not, you'll blow it out with your mouth and just close your eyes so you don't get the stuff in your eyes. But yeah, we'll clean this out real good. Make sure there's nothing in the corners, it's solid. Okay, that's just dust. Because you don't want the gasket coming, the new one coming out on its own. So we'll do that, and we'll blow it out, and then I'll take something to clean that blackness off the aluminum. Okay, just blow this out. Nice to have a compressor for things like that. All right, so it looks like alcohol cleans this up just nice. See, just a paper towel and some alcohol, and that cleans up really nice. Get all that junk out of there. There you go. Now we'll put the gasket in. All right, this is the wedge-shaped gasket. And I'm gonna just, we're gonna 45 the corners, but first we gotta get a length. So, let's see here. Which way is it going? It goes in like this. So I'm just gonna place it in the area and then mark it best I can with a ballpoint pen there. Okay, use the scissors. Now I'm very good at cutting 90 degree or 45 degree angles. So hold it in the position it's going to be in. Get your mark. See? And then just cut what you think is a 45 degree angle. You might want to trim it a little bit, but this isn't, it doesn't have to be that accurate. Now this one goes in this end, so just make sure you get it the right way. So hold it in the position it's going to be in. Cut it at a 45 degree angle. And then check your fit before you put it in the notch. See if you got it right. If it's a little too short, that's okay. What you don't want is for it to be a little too long. So let's just, it's not easy. It might be easier with the window out, but those windows, that's, I got it right, okay. So now we're just gonna poke it in there. I hope I don't have to take the window out again. Shove it down in there. And let's see. Yeah, I might have to do that. I might have to take the window out again. Let's see if I can shove it down in there with a screwdriver on top of it like this. Looks like that works. Yeah, so if you can see that, I'm just pushing it down with a screwdriver into the notch. Let me zoom in so you can see it. I'll use a bigger screwdriver. I'm figuring this out as I go because I've never done this. This is the newest trailer that I've ever restored, and it's got, so there's a lot of new stuff here. So I just push it into that notch with the screwdriver. It might even help to lubricate that notch a bit, or the rubber a bit, maybe with some Windex. I didn't think about that till just now. And you'll have to do it, move over the width of the screwdriver each time until you get it all in there, see? So once it's in, you'll know it, you'll see it. So this is the top one, that wedge-shaped one. Then we'll do the two sides, and then we'll do the bottom. All right, we've got the top in. So now we switch over to the rectangular shaped gasket. I've already cut this to a 45 on one end, so we're going to place it in there temporarily. And really, I don't know that you have to cut these at 45. I'm just doing it because that's the way the old ones were. You know, you might be able to just butt the ends. But stick it in here, get a good mark, and go ahead and cut it at 45. And then test it to see if it's going to fit. Make sure it's not too long or too short. It's perfect again. I'm really good at that though. I've been doing the gaskets for a long time. So same thing here. Just kind of push it in there. I do it first with my thumb, and you can feel it going into the notch. Okay, and just to make sure it's in there, go ahead and do it with a screwdriver. See, like this. About every quarter inch I push down on it with a screwdriver. Make sure it's down in that notch, and it is. Okay, well, that's how it's done. Just continue on around. Oops, going the wrong way with that. So basically, just finish this bottom and the right side, and that takes care of one awning pane of your window. Now, I'm going to say, if you're going to do these, the way to do this really is to take all the pane windows, the awning pane windows out, which means you have to remove the mechanisms, and you have to remove the crank mechanisms anyway in order to replace the screen, which I've already rebuilt the screens, and I just did a video on that, so it'll be a separate video. And then you can put these all back together. Now these things you can paint if you want. They're not really anything you can polish, so if you want to, paint them silver or whatever, if you don't like the finish on them. And you use a number 6 screw here. That screw is in there to keep the window from going back and forth when it's open, so that it seats back in here squarely. One little problem, there's a little plastic doohickey inside there, and you'll see it when you take these apart, and it breaks, so it's not replaceable. So if you can do all this without taking the windows out, then you won't lose that little plastic doohickey in there. That's to completely center it so there's no movement at all. In the case that it's in now, what's going to happen to you, there's a half inch wide notch there that the screw fits through. And it could, if it was slipping back and forth this way, real easy. It could slip a little bit, which would make it overlap here on the edge, and it would make it, you know, like right here, and it would make it hard to close. You'd have to come out and reposition the window. But you know what? These channels are so tight, it's not moving. And the arm, the actuating arm on here that protrudes through this metal doohickey, doohickey, don't you love this technical talk? That's the mounting bracket for the arm. It comes through here. That's going to keep it pretty straight anyway. So I wouldn't worry about it. Wouldn't worry about it at all. So there you have it. We're complete now on the video for the Alumi weld is where this all started. This was really a thing for aluminum weld, but being as how it ruins these gaskets when you heat up the metal for the aluminum weld, I needed to show you how to replace those also. And then we discovered the trick of heating the gaskets up, the old ones, to get them out of there. Now, what I've discovered after doing this a few times is you don't need to burn the gasket where it smokes. You only need to heat it up, and it'll slip right out of there. So just heat it up a bit and give a tug on it nice and deep with a needle nose, and it should slip right out. If it's not slipping right out, heat it up a little bit more. But, you know, you don't have to go nuts. You don't have to burn it. You don't need smoke. You don't need to breathe that. Alrighty, this is getting a little more involved than I really planned on doing for this particular video, but it needs to be done. Because otherwise, if you go through all this, how are you going to know how to put it all back together? Now, maybe this should be involved with the screen video to make it shorter, and I think that's what I'll do. This will actually go on the screen video. But in order to do the screens, you got to take it all apart. You have to take these crank assemblies out to get the screens out, because they actually go through the screen like this, okay, and attach over the screen. So without, if you want to redo the screens, you have to take these assemblies out. Now, the thing you're going to want to buy, here's what is on the end of these crank assemblies. Let me get over here and look and make sure you can see that okay. All right, I don't know how well that's showing. Probably pretty good. I know I got some backlight here trying to cover up with my hand. This little thing with the springs in it, if they don't come apart, that's what they look like. And if they're okay, you can just clean these and grease them up with some lithium grease or something like that and put them back in the window, okay? But if you're replacing them, you go to Vintage Trailer Supply, and I will put links in the bottom below the video here in the info section where it says show more. And I'll put links for all these parts that I bought from both Vintage Trailer Shop for the gaskets and then Vintage Trailer Supply for these things. Here's the way they come, and they don't come with a spring, but I've found that you don't really need that spring. I don't know what they're in there for, but maybe to tighten it up, keep it expanded, I don't know, but they don't come with springs. So if you lose the springs, and you don't have any, but these just fold over, just like the other ones. And then, I'm not going to do it, but they snap together like that once you put it on the end of the arm. And again, it's got the place for the springs, but it doesn't come with the actual springs. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take a new one, and I'm going to pull the spring off, one of the old ones. And of course, when you open it up, it breaks. And you see, it broke. So that's why it's good to replace these. So we've got it folded, okay, and we're going to put a spring on it, even though they're unneeded. If I could see better. We're going to put it on the end of this arm. However, you have to put the arm through, I think. I might not need to. Let's try it. Okay. I've done this before, it's just been a while. So let's see if, I hope you can see that. So what we're going to do is get the spring lined up first, and then put this on the end, and then close it so that it snaps closed. Come on. Let's see if it's, it doesn't want to stay closed is the problem. And I dropped the spring. So I probably lost the spring. That thing, even though I've got a clean floor, I can't see it anywhere. I don't know what the spring is needed for, and I can't find it. I'm looking all over. That thing bounced when it hit the ground and I lost it. So to heck with the spring, okay? I'm just gonna go ahead and close it. And lock it. I'll take a needle nose. There it's, you hear it snap and then it stays closed, okay? So that's on there. And for some reason, it you know, everything works fine without the spring. Oh, I think I just, did I find it? No, it looked like it. Yeah, I don't know where that spring went. Oh, there it is. I found it way over here. But you don't need them. They just make everything harder. So, I don't know. Okay. Now, what we got to do, see how I have the window placed? And it's propped up with the upper windows being open like that. Okay, see that? Let me see if I can zoom in here. You're looking through the screen, through that window. Now, you might have to change the position of the crank. And before you do that, I cleaned this all out. Now you want to put a little grease in there. So let's do that. You know, we take one of these, put it on there again. Heck with a spring, it's unneeded. You have to snap it, so. There. See, now I'll put a little bit of grease on that after we slip it through the screen. And I'm hoping that this all comes out great on video. That's the other hard part of this is getting it all to work. All right, so there is a large part of the slot right here. There's a matching thing on the inside of the window right up there. So that's where this thing has to go. So shove it through here first, and you might want to turn it sideways a bit to get it through this slot. Okay, it's like that. And then turn it, okay? Now, you want it pointed down, if I remember right. Yeah. And again, you might have to adjust the mechanism a bit to get it to slide in there. Oh, you know what? We want grease on the outside of that too. And I don't want to push that grease through the screen. So now that it's there, I'm going to put a little bit of grease on the outside of this thing. So I think a brush or a Q-tip would work better. And all I need to do is go get one, you know, but let's put a little bit, hope I'm not in the way, of grease on the outside of this thing. It doesn't need much, okay, because it'll move around. All right. Almost forgot. Oops. Sorry about that. My big feet grab everything.
especially the tripod.
Okay.
I'm going to try and stay out of the way. And you're going to want to guide that thing in there. Point it in there and then just slip it in. Yeah, just slip it in like that's so easy. I'm going to adjust the crank to make it a little easier. Try this again. There we go. Now this isn't the easiest thing in the world. You just have to mess with it. And I might have to mess with the window a little bit too. So it's going in the right way, but it's just hard to mess with. There. Then it'll slide down. So you see, just moving things around a little bit makes it work. And then all we have to do is, again, adjust the crank so that you can get the screw holes lined up and put the screws back in. There are Phillips head screws. Let me grab a little screwdriver here. I'll grab two of the screws, which I saved. Okay, and maybe we'll put the top one in first. No particular reason. Tighten that baby up. Put the bottom one in. Alright. There you have it. Now you have a working window. As you can see, works great. Screen is on it. Now we just do that with the other three windows and we'll be finished with this window and ready for it to install. Go down there and do the other top one and then we'll do the bottom ones. We have to reposition the window in order to do the bottom ones. Reposition it the best you can. Basically, just kind of stack up lumber or whatever to get the window up off the table so that you can open the windows and get things positioned properly to get that piece in. So we got to do it three more times and we'll be done with this window. All right, what I'm doing here to keep it, I have to keep the windows hanging open like this in order to be able to do what I got to do. So what I'm doing is just putting a couple screws in lightly to hold the window in place. I had a clamp here just temporarily. Hold the window in place, and that way my windows hang open and I can do the same thing I did to the top. So that's the trick for, you know, for the bottom windows that I've come up with. So I guess we'll start here. Just slice this like that. This one has the doohickey on it. It's an old one. I'm going to replace it. It has the spring. I'll probably I'm not going to use the spring because they just don't seem to do anything. I'll keep them, but I'm not going to use them. And we'll go ahead and put this on there like we do. Squish it closed. There we go. And we'll put it through. Well, first we'll go ahead and grease the mechanism a bit. The grease is over here now. I got a Q-tip, it's falling apart, it still works. Work the mechanism a few times. Okay. Bring the grease and the Q-tip and everything over there where we're working. Don't want to get grease on the screen. So have it about half open. All right, and we're going to place this through here. Didn't we already cut this? Yeah. There it goes. Come on. There we go. And then we'll put some grease on that. I know it's a little hard to see through the screen, but I think you get the idea now. Just not having a good time with these Q-tips. The nail worked better. Okay. Then we get to go do this again. See if you can see that. Might even be easier to go in through the top. I don't know. No, that lip's in the way. So we have to get it in here. Point it down. See, the new parts are a little wider, I think, than the old ones. So maybe Robert should be making these too so that they fit. But that's why it seems to be difficult. These new parts are just a little wider. So you got to kind of force them in there. They don't just fall into place. That's what I'm finding anyway. Now let's open this a bit. That fell out. Come on. Yeah, not easy. And you can't get it in through. Well, maybe you can get it in through the top. I'm going to give it a tap. Oh, that almost worked. There we go. Yeah, okay, now it's in. So, there we go. Aftermarket parts are always, aftermarket parts are usually either a little bit bigger or a little bit smaller by a minute amount than the original parts. And the reason for that is so that they don't interfere with patents. That's how they get away with it. If there's a patent, they don't want to get sued. So they go, well, this is our protection because it's not exactly the same. Looks the same. Doesn't work the same. Same thing is true with automobile parts, I found out. There. Now can we close that? I'm giving it a hand because of gravity. There we go. That one's closed. One to go. Grab a couple of screws. The last two. Now I got all those little springs lying around that I'm not going to use. Position this. See, everything gets easier with practice, at least. By the time you get done with your trailer, you'll be a professional. Then you can do another one, and the next one will go much faster, I guarantee it. My first trailer, I think, took 3 years. The first one I completely restored. So, and now I can probably do one in 6 months. Although, I haven't been able to do that right now because of the fact that I had to make this move, but I'm really happy about the move. So there you go. That's how you do that. This window is ready for installation as soon as I get the trailer back.